Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in this video we'll find the rotational kinetic energy of a rigid body, that is kinetic energy of a body which is rotating. So let us find that. Students, let us find the of a rotating rigid body. So I'll consider any arbitrary shape rigid body, and I'll consider the axis like so. This is the axis of rotation. Axis of rotation. Now, to find the kinetic energy, I'll consider 1, 2, and n number of particles. Supposing that let the rigid body is made up of n number of particles of masses m1, m2, mn and situated at r1, r2, rn from the axis of rotation. Now, kinetic energy of first particle is given by KE1, I suppose. Kinetic energy is a scalar quantity. It is the formula for this is half m dot product of velocities. So this is a half m. If I find that magnitude of v and cos of 0, the angle between the same vectors, 0 cos 0 is 1. So this is half mv and v. So this finally comes out to be half mv square. Dot product outcome is a scalar quantity, kinetic energy is a scalar quantity. Kinetic energy of the first particle will be half. What about the first particle? You can see here, this is the first particle, this is the second particle, suppose this is the nth particle. Here it is, the r1 is the radius. This is moving in a circular path like that. And its mass is m1. So this mass will be m2. This mass will be mn. All will be moving in a circular path. So to find the energy, it is rotating, not translating, rotating. If I consider for a moment the tangent drawn at any point on a circular path, when it is here, this linear velocity will be V1, but I am concerned with the magnitude part of the velocity, that is speed is here V1. So I will write that first particle is half m1 v1 square. This is the energy it will have. And because if I let it go, if I take a string and tie a stone and rotate and let it go at a point, if the velocity is v, then kinetic energy will be half mv square. So therefore it is half m1 v1 square. I also know that this half m1 v1 square, what is v1? Again, we know that the v equals to omega r for a particle rigid body rotation. We have already discussed that the omega will remain constant, and we assume that the body is moving with a constant omega. Then v1 will be omega r1. R1 is the position of the particle under consideration from the axis of rotation. If I square it, because V1 square, if I square this, then this will be omega square and R1 square. From here, this is half M1 R1 square into omega square. Similarly, for the second particle, I'll just copy here, it will be 2 only, M2 R2 square, omega will be remaining same. So I'll just write the order. Continuing the first particle is equal to half M1 R1 square omega square. For the second particle, the kinetic energy will be M2 R2 square omega square. For third particle, half M3 R3 square omega square. Continue like that. The last particle is half MN RN square omega square. If I have all these things, now I have to find the kinetic energy possessed by the rigid body, and the kinetic energy of the rigid body is the energy produced by each and every particles of the body. So the kinetic energy of rotation of the body is due to the kinetic energy of 1, 2 and the last particle. If I add them up here, I will have the expression of kinetic energy of rotation, which is equal to half m1 r1 square omega square plus half m2 r2 square omega square, so on up to half mn rn square omega square. If I take common, then half omega square will be common, then we are left with m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus up to so on n mn rn square. This gives me half omega square, and this is nothing but that we discussed last time, the summation of mi ri square, and I varies from 1 to n, which is half omega square into I. The kinetic energy of rotation is this one. So finally, what we're getting here is that this implies that kinetic energy, rotational kinetic energy, is given by half I omega square. This is the final expression. This is the kinetic energy of rotation. So when a body rotates, its kinetic energy will be half I omega square, where I is the moment of inertia and omega is the angular velocity. Okay, thank you.